Hello there and welcome, it's Asia Marke here, Lemon Creation, with a project I prepared for AB Studio, and today it's gonna be all about layers and all in the steampunk style, so stay tuned! So I'm working on the AB Studio paper, A Rustical Journey. And this is the paper a little bit vintage, but I decided to change it into a steampunk. And the first thing, I'm gonna apply a clear gesso and I'll use for that a card. So the application is much faster and more even. And then I'm gonna do my metal plates with rivets. And I have a video tutorial on my channel. I'm gonna give you a link here just in the top corner. For that, but you can also see it quite quickly here. This is a piece of old broken chain and I want to add the color. I want to make it a little brownish. So because of that, firstly, I am using a gesso to add some primer for it. And now I am working on choosing my colors. And these are the chipboards from Snipart. And I'm gonna be coloring them with Lindy's Gang sprays and squirts. And I will not apply any layer of gesso. Because I really don't need it, only to the MDF piece, the key you can see there. But otherwise, if you have just chipboards and they are kind of whitish in color, you can easily apply the color straight away. You don't need to apply the primer beforehand. I need to add some stenciling also, so I'm taking a texture paste from Finavar, it's a black sand, and Beaver Tail Brown Squirt from Lindy's, and I'm gonna mix them together so I actually get this brown paste, and I'm gonna use it with a AB Studio stencil. It's a stencil number 82. Now when the 3D paint is dry, I'm coloring the pieces which are gonna be looking like a metal plate. And also I'm coloring the chain, which is dry also now. And to just add some metal accents, I'm gonna be using aged brass metallic wax from Finavar. I am gonna also use this watch cameos from Tim Holtz, and to color this one I used clear gesso. You can also use white gesso. The metal will not absorb so well the paint if you don't add some primer underneath, and I could have leave it like that because it looks so beautiful with these stains. I'm just burning it myself here. But I wanted to add some more interest to this cameo, so I'm adding a paper element from Aga Baraniak again from AB Studio. You've seen I had my small box with paper elements. They are from few different set of papers by Aga, and I'm gonna be using them in this project. Now it's time to change the paper a little bit, make it look more steampunk-like. So in the middle of each box, I'm making holes and I'm putting the metal brass into them. And so like that, and the small accents like that will change it a little bit, will make it look more steampunky than actually a vintage. anyway, in my opinion. And now I am adding some sprays from Lindy's Gang. You'll find full list of products in the description box below. Remember that even with the layer of primer, if you use a lot of liquids on your paper, it can warp, so the best way is to actually dry it from both sides, alternating from one side to the other. And I'm gonna be adding some stamping, of course. The first stamp is the stamp from All and Create, and I'm using it with Black Archival ink because it's a permanent ink, so even if I want to at some point add some liquid paints, it will not affect it. And the next stamp is a Stitch and Frame from Rubber Dance. I find that some elements, they work very nicely with the steampunk theme. They are kind of metal looking. And so I'm stamping them here and there, not really paying too much attention. I just want to keep it the main focal point kind of in the middle, stretch to the side slightly. And the next stamp is Studio Light Cox. And now I'm gonna start working on my composition, so I just leave you to it. I am gluing my parts with 3D matte gel from Finavar because it's, well, I find it's one of the best glues ever. It would be quicker to use a glue gun, but then you can lose the pieces with time. And this glue is flexible and it dries clear, so that's why I use it. And so I am trying to firstly see more or less where I would like to put the parts, and then I'm gluing them to the page. All the paper elements I use for this project are coming from AB Studio by Aga Baraniak, and you'll find the link to the shop in the description box below. And I worked mainly with two paper sets, Behind Closed Doors and Steampunk Love. And this is the part when I'm adding my right now brownish chain. And I'm doing it with, again, by piercing the holes in the paper and adding some brads here and there. And I want it to kind of fall to the bottom of the page. One of the final touches is to add some of the metal accents, and for that I'm gonna be using a Finavar metallic wax, aged brass. This is one of my favorite wax ever because it has this goldish yet a little bit vintagey color. And so I'm doing it with my finger because I have more control over it. If I wanted to do it with a brush, I would have probably smeared the wax all over the photo and some of the elements, and I don't want to do it. And then I'll add some splatter with sidewalk chalk from Lindy's. And the last thing is to add some sentiments, and for that I'm gonna be using again the sentiments which comes with Aga in some of Aga Baraniak's papers. This one is behind closed doors. So thank you so much for watching, for staying here with me. This is very unusual project for me. I don't usually do that many layers, but I kind of love it. I love the girl on the photo, I love the steampunk theme. And I invite you to check AB Studio shop because there are beautiful papers there, and I hope I'll see you soon in the next video. Have a crafty day and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you, bye bye.